Welcome back. We see the handshake there between life coach and Krenich. I am Robert Worthen-Wing, joined at the desk by Savitz and Amaz. Guys, this is obviously a rematch. We had this very early on in our Hearthstone World Championship broadcast, Krenich versus life coach. And Krenich had some fun things to say to life coach. Obviously, meant very much in fun, but he was jokingly saying that he was a younger, cuter Hearthstone player and he was going to send life coach to his retirement. Obviously took the series, but was unable to advance to the top eight. Life coach has a chance for revenge. What do you guys expect to see in this series?
Well, it's interesting to see that these players have decided to go with different kind of strategies for the tournament. Krenich is playing an aggressive lineup, while life coach is going with a slow control one. And I would tend to favor Krenich in this type of situation, but anything can happen. And something like the hand lock from life coach can beat any of the decks from Krenich.
Sure. Yeah, exactly. Life Coach's handlock is not especially good in this matchup, but if he does win this match against Krenich and goes on to the top eight, this handlock is going to be really strong against other decks.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about Life Coach's lineup. A lot of players coming into the series had to make, well, obviously all the players had to make specific reads about what they were expecting to see and kind of tailor their lineup against, but Life Coach kind of kept to a very Life Coach centric roster there. We see he's going to open with handlock, but he brought a bunch of control decks, just did not go aggro at all. And obviously, you know, he's still alive in this tournament and doing well, but he himself said during one of his interviews that he doesn't necessarily feel that he read the meta super correctly. What do you make of, obviously, Handlock versus Zulok, Savitz?
I think that it's a fair matchup for Handlock. And for Life Coach, that Handlock is a problem against Krenich's lineup in general. The Druid and the Hunter would have been way worse than this is. So if you're Life Coach, you're extremely happy to see this right now. It's not an automatic win or anything like that, but I would tend to favor the Handlock.
Yeah, this is Life Coach's best lineup against Krenich's decks, the Mirror. Even though it is Handlock versus Zoo, the Handlock does have a lot of ways to board clear. But ever since, Zulok includes a lot of Death Rattle creatures, even the Imp Gang boss doesn't die to Hellfire now. Handlock has a little more struggle against Zulok, whereas, you know, back in just the classic set, Handlock would just be like the counter because Hellfire and Shadow Flame just clears out all the board.
Yeah, if there's somebody who can do it, it's going to be Life Coach. He's known for his style where he kind of sticks to his same type of strategies from one tournament to another and tries to perfect his gameplay on those particular decks.
Right. Amaz, you kind of mentioned the fact that Hellfire these days as a board clear is not necessarily as impactful because as more sets have come out, obviously we've seen these stickier minions, Piloted Shredder, Haunted Creeper, Nerubian Eggs, these kind of minions that even when you blow them up, they usually leave something behind on the board. And since that area of effect damage only happens once off a spell like Hellfire, yeah.
But looking at the hand from Krenich right now, Krenich doesn't have any of those sticky minions. Everything that he has in his hand will die to a potential coin Hellfire on turn 3 from Life Coach.
Yeah, he did. Krenich did mulligan off the Nerubian Egg in the hopes to find a more aggressive starting hand like this one so that you know, he can just put a lot of pressure on Life Coach. Maybe Life Coach doesn't have his Molten Giants right now, which would be really helpful if he can use it with like Sunfury Protector to make a big wall of taunts. But Krenich is going to go for the all-in phase, so and then hopefully draws his Doomguard or Powerwoman to end the match before Handlocks can, you know, ramp into those crazy cards.
We actually see one of those crazy cards in the hand of Life Coach Mal'Ganis, and we see the Voidcaller. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we witnessed in the last series. That's an incredibly powerful combination, capable of getting Mal'Ganis out there far earlier than turn 9. And Life Coach, Life Coach is considering his options after an eventful turn, decides to pass.
Well, I mean, you do have like, you know, 75 seconds per turn. You might as well just use them all to like think of the turns ahead, and you don't get penalized for using the whole turn. Other than, you know, perhaps the audience say, oh, you're roping, but you know, that doesn't matter when you win at the end.
Right, and for these turns that are earlier on, you know, when not as much is going on, it's kind of a good time to sit down, look at what you have in your hand, look at what kind of you expect to see based on the first couple of turns of your opponent and figure out your game plan then. Mm-hmm. Because later on, when you are stuck in more complex turns, you're not necessarily going to have time for a big picture approach to your turns. So while it's obviously fun to kind of joke around about Life Coach's turn length, there is a method to his rope madness, and it's obviously paid off. He's had an incredible 2015, along with his teammate Tyze, which, fun fact, if he were to win this series, he would advance to play Tyze, actually, in the round of eight.
Yeah, and if we get to that match, I would tend to favor Life Coach heavily against Tyze's lineup. That Priest is not very good against any of Life Coach's decks, so if they were to play, Life Coach would be in much better position than against Krenich. Krenich is going to be, it's going to be very difficult for him, but looking at this right now, he might be able to sneak in that win with the handlock, unless Krenich picks up a sticky minion for his next turn.
Yeah, the Hellfire is looking very, very juicy against Krennic's board. And yeah, Krennic needs to draw something like an endgame boss, perhaps.
Or Nerubian Egg. Yeah. But no, doesn't get any of that. No matter what Krennic does here, Life Coach is going to be able to get a full clear with his coin Hellfire next turn.
And this is kind of interesting. Going into this turn, you see, obviously, Krennic has the Voidwalker. He has the Abusive Sergeant. He would float a mana if he played both, which obviously doesn't feel good. So maybe there's a value to possibly just playing the Voidwalker and tapping, which is what he chooses to do. Obviously, if he plays down the Abusive Sergeant and the Voidwalker, that Hellfire would give it even more impactful.
Yep, that's true. And we see that Endgame Muscle is just one card away from being played, which is, you know, maybe he can just play it next turn along with another one drop. Hopefully not the Abusive Sergeant. You wanted to do something the turn you play it.
Okay, we see Earthen Ring Farseer picked up. That's a card that we'd mentioned had kind of been cut from a lot of handlock lists.
Right.
But it's very impactful in this matchup because it's a minion that comes down, it offers a little bit of healing, but more importantly, battles for the board.
Yeah, definitely helps to have it early on. Later on in the game, not the greatest top deck, but you always have the Warlock Hero Power, which can give you additional cards, and Earthen Ring Farseer is easy to play alongside the life tap.
Yeah. Earthen Ring Farseer has been cut from a lot of lists because turn 3 is usually very awkward for handlocks, right? If you're going first, you would tap in turn 3. And if you're going second, you would coin like an Azdrake or even a Hellfire at turn 3. So 3 drops are not super prevalent. That's why we only see like the Big Game Hunter being the only other 3 drop. But Life Coach here has to decide whether he wants to, you know, Hellfire and just clear this board with 7 power, or be a little bit more greedy and go for, like, you know, a Voidcaller or a Drake.
I would be kind of shocked if he went for the Voidcaller because he does not have a Molten Giant in his hand. If Life Coach had a Molten Giant, he might have just played the Voidcaller instead because he wouldn't be that worried about taking the extra damage from those minions that were already on the board.
Yeah, we do see, though, that he opts for the Hellfire, decides to play it safe, and can't really fault him. That was a lot of power on the board that he was going to have to contend with no Molten Giant, so decides to play it safe. And Krennic is going to play an Imp Gang Boss, it looks like, and actually opt to play the Abusive Sergeant just to put more on the board. Amah is very much indicative of what you said, that kind of all-in approach.
Right. Oh, Kazan Mystic is a tech card that does not work in this matchup.
No, Gul'dan has no secret.
No. But playing the Abusive actually means that Life Coach can play a 4-drop and Mortal Coil, so it's actually the perfect timing to drop the 2-1. Dropping a turn 5 means that Life Coach can actually clear and actually develop a 4-drop, so that was good. Here you can decide between a Drake or a Voidcaller, and we see Krennic does have the Owl. Not the worst of things if Life Coach gets his one of his 4-drops silenced, because he would prefer his taunts to stay intact, or even the Mal'Ganis to have his effect. So I guess it's just a preference right now, whether he wants a bit more board or wants a bit more sticky minion.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say no to the Voidcaller, though. With the Mal'Ganis, they're ready and waiting. And Voidcaller is also a tiny bit less weak to the silence effect.
Sure, but you don't really expect your opponent to have silence. And Drake does contest the endgame boss good enough that Life Coach is going to choose this option.
So of all the options he had, this one feels the least defensive. It puts something on the board. He can taunt it up next turn, but double power overwhelming. I don't think is that enough just yet.
Not yet, but that's a lot of damage. Yeah, if he
wow. Same thing.
There's so much damage right now.
And this is such a pivotal turn for Krennic. He has to make the read whether he expects Molten Giants or not. Obviously, he can't take out the Twilight Drake without using a Power Overwhelming, which he wants to keep to finish the game.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can also silence. You do want to silence and kill off the Drake because it's going to gain taunt anyways. You go like, oh, maybe I just silence it when it gains taunt. But it's a minion. Life Coach plays Sunfury and Argus, so you might as well just remove it right now. Defending the Egg right now doesn't really put too much power on the board, so I guess the only other thing Krennic is thinking about is whether to hit the face with these two creatures and reduce the life, the Hadlock's life to very low. It's very, very hard because Molten Giants would be, you know, close to cheap and close to free.
So he's going to trade in that Abusive Sergeant into the Twilight Drake. And then the Imp Gang Boss, again, he's given that consideration.
Yep. Has to think about those Molten Giants. What if Life Coach has a Molten Giant right now? Would it be better not to attack?
Yeah, it's such a tense moment when you're playing in this matchup. Really, when you're playing any more aggressive deck against Handlock, you just kind of sit there soul-searching. Does he have those Molten Giants? Mm-hmm. Obviously, we know Life Coach doesn't, so Life Coach in a little bit of a scary spot now.
Yeah. Well, thanks to Krennic's attack, he's actually 1 damage off lethal. next turn, assuming the Life Coach doesn't do anything, you know, so defensive. So like something like a Direwolf Alpha or like a Knife Juggler, yep, you know, could end the game.
Second Abusive even, yeah.
And mm-hmm. Or a Doom God, because with the power overwhelming playing it first, that would be exactly 13. I completely agree with the decision from Granite to attack here. Even though Molten Giant and Sun Fury would be kind of a problem, he does set up the lethal this way. So
every damage matters.
So the only ways he can get down Taunt at this point would be to play Iron Beak Owl as well as Earthen Ring Farseer. He could taunt either of those. But the Voidcaller costs just one mana too much to be able to combo with a taunt, which obviously he would really like to do here.
Yeah.
With Mal'Ganis sitting in hand.
Oh!
Wow. There's a Doom God. But because of the low tap effect, Kranich won't be able to play the Power of Overwhelming with the Doom God.
Now that's kind of insane. Life Coach probably doesn't realize he just saved himself from from dying to all kinds of bad demon stuff.
Kranich is still looking at a very, very good position here, since Life Coach doesn't have those Molten Giants to swing the board back in his
that
favor.
That is so much damage. With 7 mana next turn, Kranich can go double Power Overwhelming into Doom God for 13 damage directly from his hand.
He actually decides not to attack there. Doesn't want to give the free Molten Giants or the one mana Molten Giants.
And it seems like the free Molten Giants is what Kranich is going to lose to right now, right? He already used his Owl, and the only way to get back the toss is to go through the hard way, which is smashing all your minions to it and, you know, all them dying. I like that play.
If you're
Life Coach is really, really in an awkward position, right? You have 6 mana. You could taunt up the Voidcaller and the Lotheb, hopefully grab the Mal'Ganis out, and that's an extra taunt, perhaps. The other choices...
There isn't that much, I
think. Yeah, that's what I say.
Alright.
This gives you reasonable walls, and a chance of getting Mal'Ganis. That is ambitious.
Okay.
Well, let's look at his hand here.
Well, yeah, Kranich has 13 damage out of his hand. Don't think he can spread that out correctly, since the Lotep has 5 health and the Voidcaller has 4 health.
Even if the second Voidcaller comes out of the first Voidcaller, it would not be lethal for Kranich just yet. Because he has to deal 4 damage to Voidcaller, 5 to the Lotep, so Life Coach is kind of at 22 right now, so that's the amount of damage that Kranich would have to deal.
This seems to be the swing turn that Life Coach is looking for, and once again, Kranich needs to go do these taunts the hard way. Start with the Implosion.
Oh, only rolls a 2. That's really bad for him. Even if he got just a 3, he could have traded the Owl for it, but the difference between rolling a 3 and a 4 wasn't that huge, but rolling a 2, very bad.
Yeah, so unfortunately in this situation now, he's got to kind of scramble a little bit.
Yeah.
This is kind of walking away a bit from the win condition he wanted. So now he's got to decide, probably play down something like the Egg there.
Oh, so painful, just because of that low roll, having to trade in the Imkang boss in addition to the Owl.
Yeah, it also felt like that Life Coach went for the face last turn, and it's putting a lot of pressure on Kranich, and Kranich might be thinking, oh, I might be dead to like a Dark Bomb or something. Oh,
Doomguard off the top, that's not enough damage, but it's close.
Very, very
3
close.
Damage off.
Wow. So...
Yeah. Unfortunately, if he tapped looking for like a Dark Bomb, he wouldn't be able to find it. Although, now that I think about it, last time we saw this list, I don't know if we actually saw any Dark Bombs.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, really? I mean, he has to cut something to run Earthen Ring Farseer.
That's true. Maybe just one.
Right.
And maybe cutting one Mortal Coil seems valid as well. The Mortal Coil is a very strong card against a lot of aggro matchups.
Yeah, it helps a lot to deal with Belchers also, when you have a Twilight Drake out, getting that extra damage.
Well, Life Coach here, could do something cute with the demons, you know, play some demons, sacrifice your Voidcaller to put another demon perhaps. But once again, 7 mana is not really what you're looking for. Yeah. A 4 and a 3 drop would be most efficient. Silencing the Egg could be good too, if he wants to play the Doomguard.
It's interesting to see what he decides to go from here. He is looking to heal his own Voidcaller.
Yep. And then plays this other Voidcaller so that the Doomguard and the Mal'Ganis has a bigger chance. Well, has the only chance.
I believe
to
that's
come up.
Actually lethal for Kranich here if Life Coach gets the Doomguard from that. Because with the Power of Overwhelming on the Nerubian Egg, dealing 4 to that, he has 4 extra on the board, 9 in his hand. So this is a 50-50 moment right here. Does he get the Mal'Ganis?
That is not the right one. And Life Coach is not happy about that. Yeah.
Life Coach, you had one job, Voidcaller. Come on. Team effort. That is going to be game. Kranich just snatches it away. Wow. And to be fair, like that one looked like it was kind of getting away from Kranich once those taunts came down. The implosion rolled for two.
But Life Coach did draw some weaker cards there. Getting that Kazan Mystic, for example, it didn't really help that much.
Yeah, at the end of the day, it seems like that 13 damage burst from a Zoo is a lot, you know? Zoo can burst your opponent.
Sure.
That's
is.
What it's made to do. And the Power of Warming also made it so that the trading with the taunt was very, very efficient. And yeah, Kranich gets a Zoo out of the way. It was a really strong deck against Life Coach's lineup anyways, but it's always good to have the first win.
Oh yeah, and that was an important one for Life Coach. Now with his handlock, it's only going to get more difficult than that if that was. Yeah. So even though it's only 1-0 for Kranich, I think Life Coach is in a lot of trouble right now.
Right, so Kranich obviously takes a 1-0 lead in the series, and we've talked to Kranich a little bit about the fact he's the only player returning to BlizzCon and how confident that makes him.
Welcome back. There we saw Life Coach. Quite nervous. Not happy about that at all. I mean, there's a lot on the line. Can't blame him.
Yeah, it seems like that match did get stolen away from him. So we'll have to see if he gets his confidence back in the second match, and hopefully he does it.
Yeah, Life Coach is a very experienced player. It's not the first time he's in a spot like this. And I'm sure that mentally he can reset that thing and just like focus on the next game and not worry too much about what just happened.
Yeah, that's very true. So... we have a special guest right now with us. Welcome to the table.
Thanks. I just want to point out real quick, Life Coach has to kind of look at that not as a mistake, but as a happy accident kind of game. And he's going to get right back in for game two. I believe in Life Coach. Okay. Glad to be joining you guys. Obviously, I'm a big fan of streams, as I said last night. Big fan of streams. Love streams.
It's very nice for you to take the time out of your very, very busy day and come join us to cast a game of Hearthstone.
I've been so popular on Twitch lately. And I love Hearthstone so much. I just figured I'd come on out and cast some Hearthstone with you guys. Hmm. Rob had to go to the bathroom anyway, so it seemed like a good time.
No mistakes. Okay.
It was a very fun time. Yeah. I agree.
Who do you think is going to win, Kranich or Life Coach?
Tough to say. Life Coach, very, very calm individual. Very placid, very, very nice guy. I really like Life Coach, but that Kranich is a cute gamer boy. I really like him too. Yeah. A lot of happy surprises coming.
No mistakes.
All right. Well, it seems like the game has started, which saves us some time here looking at each other. Life Coach is Kranich. He's going to play against...
We see actually in Kranich's hands, he's got a couple little trees there. And I really like those little trees. I hope he keeps them. That board's going to look a lot nicer with those trees on them.
Why is it that trees are, you know, so interesting?
They're just very happy. You know, you look at a tree, it's hard to be mad. Mm. Just get very excited about trees.
All right. Well, Life Coach definitely is not a big fan of trees and is looking to crush Kranich's Druid here with his Handlock. It's not going to be a good matchup. But this hand is also not looking too good.
Yeah,
for Life Coach.
Well, both players with pretty bad hands. No mana cards for Kranich right now. He's really looking for either Wild Growth or a Darnassus Aspirant. Innervate would also help. Life Coach with no play for turn four right now.
It's really, really slow hands for both of them. Very non-aggressive, nice and peaceful. They don't really look like they want to fight each other. A lot of high mana cards, and don't worry about it later right now.
Yeah, we can see that Kranich doesn't even have a Wild Growth or an Innervate, so it's going to be looking like a hero power into a hero power, which is very, very bad.
Awful hand.
Yeah, Kranich. But then Life Coach, on the other hand, also doesn't have any 4-drops, so it seems like both players are fishing for those key cards.
Everyone wants to find that Wild Growth. It's such a pretty card. Very, very close to nature.
It does seem like it's a painting done by you.
Oh, wow, I appreciate the compliment, but I'm not of that skill level yet.
Whoa.
All right, well, there's the Wild Growth.
I'm really glad he could get that. That makes me very happy.
All right, nice
happy surprise.
All right. Kranich still needs to look for a 5-drop, though. Not the best curve. And meanwhile, at Life Coach's hand, well, at least he can play an Ancient Watcher. Coining a Void Caller isn't the best option here, since he doesn't have another 4-drop to follow up.
No demon in his hand right now, so that would be kind of surprising. If he decided to go with that, he might be trying to bait out a silence from Kranich in that case, because Kranich doesn't know Life Coach doesn't have any demons.
Yeah, the bluffing strategy always works with Void Caller. Sometimes the longer you think in ladder, the more they think that, they don't have it, right?
Right.
But Life Coach always pays so that, you know, bluff is all out of the way.
Mm. Void Caller would be a nice addition to the board, though. We see a nice magenta-hued color demon there. A little bit of darker orange-red. Really gonna improve this otherwise kind of bland canvas we've got going on the board right now. No minions.
Yeah. All right. Well, in that case, what is the most beautiful class based on their decks and colors?
I think that's a very straightforward answer, Amaz. It's obviously Druid. He's already got trees in his hand. He's got another one.
Okay.
So many trees for Druid. You got Ancient of War, Ancient of Lore, Force of Nature.
I walked right into that one, I think.
You kind of set yourself up there for it, friend.
Life Coach actually just going to coin out the Void Caller in here.
Oh, wow. That's a very decent 5-drop by Kranich. We know that the best play by him right now would be to charge and kill the Void Caller off, right?
Yeah, but he doesn't know that. I would be shocked if he actually decided to go with that play.
The manly play.
Yeah.
You would do that, right, Savish?
Just risk it. Yeah, there's no demon, obviously. If you Kranich, there's two options, really. Either the Keeper of the Crow for the silence if you're worried about Doom cards and that kind of stuff, or he could just go with the Druid of the Claw Taunt, which we know would work out better in this situation.
Does go for the safe play. Can't blame him.
It's hard to know. It's hard to know what's behind that Void Caller. You can't really judge a painting until it's finished, and this Warlock hand clearly has a lot of stuff yet to be seen.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Lots of surprises.
Happy surprises, though.
All right. Speaking of surprises, Life Coach, Kazan Mystic comes in again. And doesn't get any value once again.
Again, like
4 mana, 4/3, you know? So you can actually decide between, you know, taunting up the Ancient Watcher, perhaps. Playing a 4 mana, 4/3 seems pretty bad, but not the worst option right now.
I don't think you go with the Kazan. You got to protect the Void Caller. If he chooses to play the Kazan and not attack, it's fairly obvious that there's no demon, because otherwise he would have just pulled it out with the Void Caller. Life Coach really wants to tap, but if he does choose to tap, he cannot protect the Void Caller. So he needs to make a decision here between keeping the Void Caller or
almost out of time.
Or life tapping.
Yeah, I guess I would prefer the taunting of the Ancient Watcher here. It does make your other turns quite hard, since you use a lot of small mana minions. But I mean, come on, like Lotheb into Emperor into Dr. Broom seems like a pretty good curve.
Yep, and he does go with that. Also taunting up the Void Caller. I'm a tiny bit surprised that he chose to go with that. Maybe he wants to hide the fact that there is no demon waiting on the other side.
You guys brought up an interesting point. That Kazan Mystic, great card in its own right. Does a lot of powerful stuff in the right scenario, but it's all about bringing the right tools when you're making your masterpiece. And when Life Coach looks down at his color palette, he sees a lot of nice demons and silences. And Dr. Boom's always a great one to have too. Very powerful color, but Kazan Mystic's maybe not the tool for this job.
Not for this game especially, but maybe for another game it'll bring more clarity to the board.
What do you think he's looking to use that tool on, Amaz?
Perhaps Kranich's Hunter, which Kranich's has, but not this one. So we'll have to save the surprise for later.
Yeah, okay, Kranitz here with 6 mana. Time waits for no one. There's a few options. It seems like the Silence would be kind of the obvious one, the white color.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow, going for the Ancient Watcher kill, that can never feel good. If you're going to, you know, remove a 2-drop just by killing of the Druid of the Claw. That effectively is like a bigger Dark Bomb, right?
Very nice for Kranich, or very nice for Life Coach. Kranich, you know, obviously, doesn't understand. Life Coach had no demons at the time.
Yeah.
That Void Caller was a big old bluff, big old lie.
Yeah, Life Coach pretty proud of himself. I'm assuming that he did get the Void Caller to get Silence and get Valued that way. And now turn 5, pretty easy Lothep here.
Yep.
The trading is also pretty nice with the Sun Fury against the Druid of the Claw.
Yeah, definitely a lot. Nothing else really makes any sense. If he went for the life, that it's possible that he had no minion to play at all.
It's easy to look at that Keeper of the Grove and think that maybe Kranich ruined it a little bit, but he didn't ruin it. It was just he was playing to what he thought might be there, and that's sometimes something you got to do in these high-level tournaments.
Absolutely.
There you go. Kranich actually played the top deck Ancient of Lore immediately, which if Life Coach is just looking at what Kranich is doing, might come to the conclusion that he only has one Ancient of Lore. You know, sometimes these edges help the overall match, right? You just want to pick those small advantages when you can.
Yep. And here, 6 mana available. Mountain Giant and Emperor Thoris and both seem kind of like decent plays. I'd expect him to trade low, but yeah, just go for it.
Really sad. Really sad Life Coach got rid of that tree. That tree was making the board look a lot nicer. Now it's gone.
Hope but Lothep is not a tree. Oh, I mean, okay.
Ancient of Lore is a tree.
Okay, I get what you mean.
Kranich with quite a few tools here. Just choose whatever he wants.
Yeah.
There's a lot of good plays.
I think what Kranich is thinking about is the possibility of double combo since his innovator is in the hand. So Kranich is just looking to stabilize the board and not get the handlock out of hand. So to say.
Out of hand. That was delightful. I like that. So very happy. So happy, by the way, that Kranich is playing Druid.
Oh, yep. Man. And just maintain board pressure, just clear the board, and get a 22 damage combo out to finish the game, perhaps.
That'd be a lot of damage. There's a lot of trees.
Starts with a Wrathful One, picks up the Emperor Thoris, not his own. Is there a way for him to get the Emperor out right now and deal with the Emperor from Life
Coach's
side?
Not exactly right now, it seems like. So it's just going to clear the board once again. Emperor can just come down next turn. That's perfectly fine.
It's true.
As well.
It's going to be quite good. He could even go for the second lore before playing the Emperor to get even more value with
That's true. But reducing down double Savage Roar is already like a huge deal.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yep. Yeah, Darnassus Aspirin comes down. She is riding the cat. That's very nice. A lot of cats like those. But that's going to give her an extra mana crystal, too.
On turn 8, not really too crazy, but at least establishes a minion, I guess. And of course, Kranich looking to Emperor the 2 Savage Roars. Doesn't seem like he needs to innovate, so he just goes ahead and plays a little bit more board. So set up for the Emperor and Shredder next turn, and then see where to go from there.
Yep.
Life Coach, a handful of minions is going to be... It's going to be quite a difficult task to respond to Kranich's board right now. I guess Dr. Boom is the best option here, just to, you know, try and take back the board.
Most likely he will not life tap here, considering that with those two minions on the board, Kranich with a Force of Nature Savage Roar would be threatening 22 damage.
Obviously, the Druid here looks to do its painting all in one turn. Get all that damage and just finish up right then and there, whereas Life Coach would like to take this a little bit longer, kind of take his time on his work, and Druid's not really going to let him have it.
Nope. There's the Kazan. Effectively a pilot less Shredder in this matchup.
that's a good one. Because most Shredders are piloted. I like it.
And there's the Force of Nature for Kranich.
And yeah, once again, Emperor is going to be super effective here in making Kranich's hand be able to play double combo right from his hand. And I really can't see any other play. And of course, you can back that up with Shredder as well. Maybe it's a little bit weak to Hellfire or Shadow Flame, but just establish, you know, the minions and just go for the win next turn.
I don't think he's too worried about those right now.
Mm-hmm.
So there needs to be the AoE and some ridiculously strong taunts.
Yeah. And because Life Coach is at a life total of 24, Kranich doesn't even have to worry about any Molten Giants coming down the board. Right.
Oh, Sun Fury Protector, very important draw. But is it going to be enough?
Usually it is, because Sunfury Protector, even taunting a one health creature like a Boombot perhaps, will soak a lot of damage, right? It'll soak perhaps 4 damage from the hero attacking from the double Savage Roars. So taunts actually mess up the Force of Nature really, really badly.
Yep. Taking his time, looking like he's in pain.
Well, the only thing he can really do to get rid of that Emperor Thorsand is put down the Doomguard, but he looks so angry. That Doomguard is yelling. He's really going to ruin the vibe of this whole game. Just coming down, shamming, shouting.
Okay.
So our Doomguard, Sunfury Protector Doomguard would let him get a full clear here, but he would discard 2 cards, and one of those could be the Dr. Boom.
So would you want to play Doomguard first, and perhaps discard one of the Owls?
It's an interesting
thought. It's very risky, and Life Coach, thinking his brains out here.
He's gonna go for the Dr. Boom, but...
Oh!
That means that he will not play the taunt.
And that is it!
Yeah, that's Kranich, going...
That's a lot of damage. 22 from the hand, and 9 from the Emperor.
Oh my goodness,
Hero
power.
Might as well throw in the interface.
23 from the hand, and 9 on body. 32 damage for
Trees are celebrating, they're just... They're doing a lot of damage, the big numbers, they're happy, they're dancing, they're charging. I really like what Kranich has done. These are happy trees.
All right, well, of course, once you join the desk, the Force of Nature does pick up a win here, and congratulations goes to Kranich. He's up 2-0.
Yep.
Only has his hunter left now. And Life Coach with his hand look still.
Oh, man.
It's going to be rough. It's doable, though, with the right cards.
Yeah. It's not necessarily that Life Coach read the meta wrong, it's just that he's facing an opponent that's built a lineup very, very strong against control decks. And the Handlock is one of those decks where, you know, you have to wrap up early on and play these big creatures later on. And yeah, Kranich just Zulok did it really well, and the Druid was a lot of pressure. And Life Coach needs to win 3 straight now, which is going to be really hard.
Yeah. I wonder if it's like...
Thank you, Savish. Obviously, we saw a great game there. Just a ton of fun. I'm super happy I got to cast this Hearthstone match. We used Kranich, who's a lovely palette of nature and trees, and it ultimately proved to win him the game, so he's got a commanding lead in this series. I've got to go right now. I've got more paintings to do, but thank you for having me. It's been a lot of fun, and bye-bye.
It's nice having you with us.
Yeah, what a nice and inspiring visit from the man himself.
Sure was.
Yeah, we're going to miss him, right?
Absolutely.
Are you going to miss him?
I am. But let's get back into the match.
Ethan Kranich is just like a big favorite, right? What
absolutely.
Can Life Coach do? I mean, obviously you want momentum to be back on your side first, so you want to go with the best class. So if you were a Life Coach, what would you pick here?
I would probably... Well, all of these are not very good against it, but maybe with the Warrior.
Okay.
There's a lot of tools in that can deal with the early minions from Kranich. With those weapons, for example. That hand, look, might want to wait for a little bit later with it. We didn't even see any dark bombs, right?
Yeah, we didn't
see a single dark bomb, and that's very important early on against Hunter.
It's such a reactive card, and a couple of the Doomguard can actually burst your opponent down from, you know, very high amounts of health that perhaps you expect Handlock not to make from, you know, just very rampy cards like Giants and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. We do know that his Warrior deck is a very, very control-heavy, right? Just because Trueheart might get the health lead he needs to beat a Hunter.
Yeah. Early on, that's where the troubles might come. If the Hunter has a nice curve, goes 1, 2, 3, 4, it can be the early damage just might be too much, and those slow, expensive legendary minions might be too late.
Yeah, playing on curve is definitely a very, very important thing to do. And hey, Rob, you decided to join us back.
Yeah, where were you?
I actually ended up getting lunch. I saw Bob though in the hall. Seems like he took good care of you guys. So, I'm super glad. Looks like we're getting right into game 3 here. So Kranich up 2-0 on Life Coach, and mid-range Hunter versus Control Warrior.
Yeah.
Certainly a matchup that, you know, over time we've seen really kind of go to the Control Warrior. But to the mid-range Hunter, but I think the Control Warrior has a pretty good chance here.
Yeah, it's definitely a matchup of the ages. Back when Control Warrior was super prevalent, people were like, oh, let's just bring Sivana High Main to beat the Warriors, right? So really what Life Coach is going to do in this match is to figure a way to kill the Sivana High Main, the first one, because you don't expect the second one, and then just, you know, win from there.
Yep. He's got a good early curve for it, too.
Yeah, not bad at all. Does start with that web spinner. The mid-range Hunter very low on one drops, but he does get it here. definitely helps.
And for Live Coach, kind of the name of the game, at least for this turn, will probably at some point end up being Armor and Pass.
Yep.
But Live Coach is going to take his time, figure out what he wants to do. Krannich's hand is just full of spiders, which feels awkward to say, but there they are.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. It's spiders. A very spooky hand, even.
Yeah.
Spooky spiders.
It's also the
lines.
Tavern Brawl, right?
Yeah.
Very thematic.
Krannich, you know, like some others, big role player. So.
Oh, you're calling Krannich a role player now.
I am. I'm calling him out.
Okay. Yeah. Well, Krannich is going to show you and he's going to win this game and go move on to BlizzCon.
Yeah, I was going to say, Life Coach, you know, for him, this was a chance to kind of get a little bit of revenge, but Krannich so far is doing work.
Yep.
You see here, Life Coach has that Acolyte of Pain he can put down. He could also play down the Big Game Hunter if he wanted to, but with those one attack minions, it's kind of too tempting to just draw all those cards.
Yep.
Yeah, you definitely want to go for the Acolyte here. He knows that Krannich does have a Dr. Boom in his deck as well, so holding on to that Big Game Hunter for later on is very valuable.
Eagle Horn Bow, great counter to Acolyte of Pain. Gonna ensure that it basically ends up just being a cycled card, and he's gonna be able to continue pushing aggression and might just save that coin. Probably just save that coin for the high main.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Now, it's very important for Life Coach to establish this Fire War Axe since he's going to play a Belcher next turn. He wouldn't have any answers for perhaps a Pious Shredder from Krannich, or even what he has right now, a Knife Juggler plus a Haunted Creeper. If he decides to cycle for more cards, he might get punished a little bit.
Krannich being able to get to that turn 5 Savannah High Main will be huge for him. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, Life Coach, right around, as you pointed out, turn 5 here, he's going to have the Sludge Belcher. He has another Sludge Belcher. He could even look at using something like Shield Block, Shield Slam to get rid of the initial body of the Savannah High Main. So Life Coach is actually in a pretty reasonable spot here, I think.
Yeah.
It's not looking bad at all. Has those tools. Shield Block, Shield Slam, easy way to deal with the High Main. Equipping the weapon here, considering whether or not he should hit something with it. It's actually a tough call because it doesn't accomplish all that much to kill either one of those minions.
Yeah, that's true.
You're only killing one, so the Houndmaster could come down.
Yeah,
so.
In any case.
Yeah.
I might just armor up and pass. It goes for the Haunted Creeper.
Yep, let's decide that the Haunted Creeper, if it gets Houndmastered, it will turn to a 4-elf creature. Whereas the Westbinder would turn into a 3-elf creature, which still dies to the axe.
Yeah, makes sense.
Really important consideration. So this is now the Animal Companion draw. I feel like maybe complicates this turn a little bit. You probably still keep the coin for the high main, but there is a world where if you're really looking to put on the pressure, you could Knife Juggler, coin, Animal Companion. You know, even Leok would be really solid here. Mm-hmm. Huffer, obviously always appreciated in situations where you're trying to push the board. And with the Fiery War Axe equipped, maybe even Misha's not all that bad. So
yeah.
Really, there's any scenario where anything he gets off this Animal Companion is super useful.
Yep, and Krannich agrees with you and gets a Misha. Perfect.
Yep. And he holds onto the coin, so he's not putting down as much pressure into the board, but it's also important to know he's going into the Brawl turn.
That's true. Luckily for Krannich, this isn't a board that Life Coach really wants to Brawl. I mean, if he really has no answers, he will use the Brawl, and then Krannich, I think he will be pretty happy about it, right? Dr. Broom is a card that's pretty weak to Brawl in general. So now Life Coach without a Whirlwind effect. This is a bit tricky for him. Perhaps a Belcher could stall a little bit.
Yep, with the double Belcher in his hand, it makes a lot of sense to get one of those blades right now, even though it's not that perfect against Krannich's board.
It might not be the play he ultimately goes with here, but you could Shield Box, Shield Slam, get rid of the Misha, swing into the Web Spinner. You take all the beasts off the board. Obviously, you're not developing that Sludge Belcher, which is very important for keeping the damage away. But that Sludge Belcher, if it comes down and it just gets silenced, Krannich is suddenly pushing a fair bit of damage. So even though he has a Sludge Belcher to follow up, it's also a question of kind of can he stay, I guess, afloat in the tempo.
No one does that.
Yeah, he just goes for the Shield Slam. And with this play, I would imagine that he's going to swing at the webs now, but he might not, because he might not have the extra mana to equip the second action next turn. So he wants to keep it for a potential Shredder or something along those lines.
Oh, speaking of which, the silence does come in
hand. Yeah, there it is.
For Krannich, and just coin high main. This is the turn you're waiting for to do exactly that.
It would be best case scenario, obviously, Krannich draws a second high main next turn and just high main, Dr. Boom.
But one high main is enough because the high main rule states that if you play a high main when your opponent has no board and it connects to the face at least one time, you win the game.
Is that an established rule?
That is an established rule.
That.
Yep.
That's I believe it though, based on my experience.
One of my 100 established rules that seem to work every time.
If you would publish those, I would love to read them.
Oh. All right.
Yeah, normally in my 100 decks there is no spin high main, so I'm actually not super sure how it works.
No, I meant in your 100 decks.
Just face?
Oh,
it doesn't have charge, so...
Doesn't have charge either.
No, Spanna High Main... No, but I'm saying Spanna High Main doesn't have charge, so it's not really... Something I want to run.
So it's not your kind of Hunter deck. No, not my kind of Hunter deck.
The scumbag Hunter.
Wow, really aggressive. I prefer to think, you know, a busy man. Things
okay.
to do. You know, sometimes I want to get in a game while I'm drinking my coffee, and after those games, I need to go fast. So I need charge minions. Life Coach, not going to go fast here. He's going to get the Sludge Belcher down.
Doesn't have an option, really.
Yeah, that's a tricky turn for him. And ooh, with the kill command off the top, this is going to represent a lot of damage very quickly.
Yeah, this is getting so problematic for Life Coach. He didn't have a good way to deal with that high main, and the board is only going to get worse and worse.
And we see Jeskar Trueheart in Life Coach's hand, which a lot of times can be the decider as far as stalling out the match, but right now, he's facing down so much damage.
Yep. Yeah, where does he find the time to play the Justicar?
Right.
Well, Life Coach really just needs the Brawl to, you know, stabilize the board, hopefully come back from the game with the Justicar. But Kranich's hand is looking really, really good. Dr. Broom next turn with a kill command to follow up later on. And he's also going to draw a card before that happens, right? Perhaps like another kill command would be pretty crazy.
I don't really see a way for Life Coach to turn this around unless he draws a Brawl. Without a Brawl, a board like this is almost impossible to clear.
I think he was there. So he was searching to see if he could get the Knife Jungle to hit the Sludge Belcher before he silenced it. This is still good. There's nothing on the board, and as you said, unless he finds a Brawl really soon here. All right, Amaz, it hit the face once.
Yep.
Let's see if your rule holds.
Exactly. Like, Kranich really wanted to hit the face, right? But, oh, this Despite was really late. If Life Coach actually equipped this to turn 4, this board might not have looked like this.
Do a little bit of math here and see if there's a world, I think.
He can go for some kind of Death Spite into Fire War Axe play just to get the Whirlwind Defect off. He has one extra for the Execute as well, but is it enough?
This is it's important to note, Life Coach has 2 Executes in hand, but they kind of just aren't super effective here. There's so many minions on the board with 1 health. Savannah Highman will ultimately make 2 Hyenas, and with the Knife Jogger on board, it's even worse. So
right,
you have to get rid
exactly.
of that first.
But right now, Life Coach has to solve the problem in front of him. The only Whirlwind effect is from breaking his own Despite, so possible play might be just equip the Despite, you know, perhaps swing with it, and then get the Fire War Axe to kind of override it for the Whirlwind effect.
He kind of has to do it. It's not that great, but I think he has to go for it.
You still have mana left over to execute the Savannah High Main, so.
Yep.
It's not that bad, judging from the situation.
Yeah, wasting the Death Spite in some way. And seems like he's going to go for something else. Probably the Belcher.
Okay.
Belcher always feels safe to play. You're like, come on, save me, Belcher. Save me.
Well.
Well, it will save him, it looks like, for this turn.
Yeah, it's and now Kranich has 2 options, right? Dr. Broom for 7, or we can do the Oasis plus Kill Command for 7 as well.
Well, he's got to actually get rid of some minions on the board if he wants to get full value from the Boom Boss.
That's true. So he might just go along with the Kill Command and Savannah High Main rule Life Coach's face again.
Yeah, that's Savannah High Main there for 3rd turn already and still at full health. So when High Main survives that long, if you're the Hunter player, you know you're doing good.
The 2015 debut of Oasis Snapjaw, is it? No, not yet.
Plays around the Brawl a little bit. Kranich knows that Life Coach doesn't have it, but Life Coach could draw it from the top.
Yeah, I'm not seeing a way out of this one for Life Coach.
He might be roping for the last time.
I mean, for
this
game,
tournament.
Obviously.
That is brutal.
Obviously.
That is absolutely. No, to be honest, here he can, despite the Creeper, right, replace it with another weapon, execute the Savannah Hyman, and he'll be down at 1 health.
Wow.
And, hey, Kranich doesn't have 1 damage.
I mean, where would he find it?
You can't find it for Unleash the Hounds.
No, that's not going to do it.
Yeah.
Unleash no good for now.
Unleash no good. So maybe Life Coach top decks in Alexstrasza,
maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously, dark situation for Life Coach, but you just have to try to stay alive for now.
Mm-hmm.
See what you can find.
That's really the only way to stay alive.
And the one plus side I see for this, for Life Coach, is that Kranich is not running that charge-heavy Hunter, so there is a chance he just draws, like, a second Web Spinner or something.
Okay, well, Life Coach doesn't even want to take that 1 damage from the Hunter Creeper.
Wow.
Goes ahead and replaces the weapon like this, executes the Savannah High Main, and now he can actually kill one of the Hyenas.
Yeah, not that great turn, but he's doing what he can. Down to 6 HP. Kranich needs just two more damage to end the series.
Oh, that's not it.
Dr. Boom and Web Spinner too. That what a curve-friendly turn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You have to float the mana. Golden Dr. Boom, no less.
There it is.
Oh,
Life Coach does have a big game, Hunter, but there's still those Doom Boo bots. And,
there's not the card you want to draw right now. And I think that's it. There's actually no way for Life Coach to get out of this situation. And
I believe so.
Yeah, Kanish is going to take the series and advance to BlizzCon.
We'll see just what happens here, but I feel like you're right. He's going to see if maybe he can try to float the... Nope. Yeah, just obviously we know Pure Power, pretty solid, but yeah, that's it's gonna do it. That is going to do it for Life Coach.
Oh yeah, Kranich breathed a sigh of relief, while Life Coach seems a little bit disappointed, and rightfully so.
Kranich and Life Coach exchange very polite, well played. Obviously they're competitors, have a lot of respect for each other, and I like seeing that. I feel like we don't necessarily see that enough in Hearthstone, but you know, Kranich understands that even though he was the Asia Pacific champion, beating a player of Life Coach's caliber is still something to be super like respectful about, right? Life Coach is an incredibly well-known player. Obviously, 2015, I think prior to Ty's being on this kind of tear he's on now, was largely considered the year of Life Coach because of all the things he was winning. So, congrats to Kranich. Great to see.
Yeah, great showing from Life Coach still. He made it a long way to get here, finishing in the a little bit before BlizzCon, but he'll still be there. He'll still be enjoying the event. Unfortunately, not playing.
Yeah, on the other hand, Tice will be representing Life Coach's team, G2, and he's going to be cheering for his teammate. So it's not like the end of the world for Life Coach.
Yeah.
He was still root for his teammate.
Yeah, good teammates.
Thing.
And I'm sure that Life Coach will also be helping out Tice as much as he can to maybe try help Tice become the world champion this year.
Mm-hmm. Right. Speaking of Tice, he actually was talking earlier on Twitter about the fact that even though he would have to play Life Coach, if Life Coach won, and he felt that Life Coach was favored against his lineup, he was still rooting for Life Coach because they're very good friends. They obviously, for Tice, he would rather play Life Coach than see Life Coach not make it. But maybe Tice is breathing a small sigh of relief that he won't have to take on his friend in the round of eight.
Yep.
All right, and now we actually have Kranich ready for his second interview of the Hearthstone World Championship. Rachel, take it away.
Thanks so much, guys. I am here with Kranich, and Kranich, You faced Life Coach twice in this tournament. You did an incredible job in this last round, 3-0. Who is left that you're even a little bit afraid of in this top eight?
Well, there are so many strong players who are already in the quarterfinals, but like Tice must be most fearsome player because he will just prepare to revenge his teammate. So yeah, I mean like he'll be the most hard opponent, I guess.
Yeah, he might be out for revenge on you after knocking out Life Coach, but we'll see if he's able to take it. Now, what has been the biggest difference for you between last year playing and this year playing at BlizzCon?
Well, I think this year is like the tougher one, I guess. I mean, like I had only three match this year, but like I'm really I'm already really exhausted because of so tough matches, and yeah, I mean the competition is real. I think this year is like harder.
This year is it might be harder. You're the one to tell us the difference between the two. But if you're so tired, I'll let you guys go rest. We have more Hearthstone matches coming up next. Please don't go anywhere.
So as Kranich said, obviously, you know, he has to face down Tice next. No small feat. Tice has kind of tailored his matchup or his roster to kind of dealing with decks like Kranich's. So for Kranich, it's going to be a few days of kind of studying, hitting the books, trying to figure out what he can do to give himself the edge in this upcoming rest of the Hearthstone World Championship. But very strong showing from him and very strong showing from the Asia-Pacific regions thus far in the Hearthstone World Championship.
Yeah, definitely. Tice is going to be a tough opponent for him. But if he can get past Tice, he might even take it all.
Okay. All right, we want to take a quick second here to thank our sponsors for helping to make the Hearthstone World Championship possible. Obviously, go take a look at all the stuff they are putting out there. Very good stuff, and we're super happy to have their support. But before we get into our next match, let's have a quick look at some of the highlights from the last series brought to you by Windows 10 Game DVR.